In this lesson, we'll take a look at ways to take the scene to the next level by using photometric lights and cameras. Start by opening rendering bstart.max file. We'll look at the photometric lights. In the Create panel, go to Lights, and in the drop-down menu, choose Photometric. The target and free light are essentially the same light, whereas the target light has a target control to help orient the light. The sun positioner is a way to create natural daylight for the sun and sky. We will explore the sun positioner in the next lesson. Let's create a free light. Click on the Free Light button. We get a pop-up dialog. It is recommended that you use the logarithmic exposure control. We need to control how much light is reaching the sensor in our virtual camera. You want to have exposure control enabled when using photometric lights. Select Yes on the dialog. Create the free light in the top viewport on the left of the train station. Then, in the left viewport, move the light above the train station. Select the perspective view and render. It looks dark and needs shadows. Go to the Modify panel. In the General Parameters, turn on Shadows. And from the drop-down menu, change the shadow type to Ray Trace Shadows. Then, in Intensity Color Attenuation section, in the Intensity group, change 1500 to 20,000. The reason we jump to such a high number is that photometric lights behave like lights in the real world. Their light decays over distance. The farther the light is from the scene, the higher the intensity needs to be to light the scene, according to what is called the inverse square law. The intensity group specifies the strength or brightness of the photometric lights in physically based quantities. The default is CD or candela. Photometric lights are based on real-life counterparts. This means that if you need to place a 60-watt lamp in the scene, you choose a 60-watt lamp from the template list. Keep in mind that photometric lights are better used with the ART or Arnold renderers. Another important factor for using photometric lights is that the scene should be built to scale. Render the frame again. It looks better, but is still too dark. In real-world lighting, light bounces around the space. But the scanline renderer does not support this light bouncing. So we need another light to simulate light bounce, also called indirect light. Create another free light in the top viewport. Place it in the middle of the train station. Then, in the left viewport, move the light so it is inside the train station. Change the CD candela to 3000. Render again. It looks better, but this scene really needs more advanced rendering like ART or Arnold to make it look more realistic. Let's take a look at cameras. Camera objects simulate still image, motion picture, or video cameras in the real world. The physical camera is the best camera type to use for photorealistic, physically based rendering, which we will focus on for this lesson. Physical cameras integrate framing the scene with exposure control and other effects that model real-world cameras. Go to the Create panel, select Cameras, and select Physical. Go to the front viewport. Click to the left of the train and drag towards the platform. Now we need to assign a viewport as a camera. Select the perspective viewport and use the keyboard shortcut C to load the selected camera. In the top viewport, move the camera object to the right and you will see the camera viewport update. You can move the camera from any viewport or use the camera navigation tools in the bottom right of the interface to edit the camera. Now select that camera and delete. The camera viewport switches back to a perspective viewport. A much easier way to create a camera is through the perspective viewport. Adjust the perspective viewport until it has a framing that you desire. Then press Ctrl-C. Once the camera is in the scene, you can adjust it further so you can see the moving people and the door of the train opening and closing. When a project is done, you want to render it. If there is any animation, then the entire animation range will need to be rendered. Start in the Render Setup dialog. In the Common tab, select Active Time Segment, which will render the frames that are set in your scene. For this scene, it is set from 0 to 200. In the Output Size section, in the drop-down menu, choose HD TV Video. Then, in the Presets, choose 480 by 270. It's a smaller size, but it will take less time to render. In the Render Output section, click on the Files button. This will bring up an Explore window. It should be in the Render Output folder from the Train Station project. Name the file Rendering B Final and choose the file type AVI file. Then choose Save. In the AVI file compression setup, select MPEG compression from the compression drop-down menu and set the quality to 100. An AVI is not recommended typically for a final render. But for now, this would serve as a higher quality preview. The last thing to be done is click the render button. How long the render takes really depends on the scene size and the quality of the render. When you render a sequence or movie file, you get the Rendering Progress dialog. This shows the status of your render, things like what frame is being rendered and the time remaining.